Hey guys, it is me, Hypposarika, and welcome back to Dota Zombie Survival. So Dota Zombie Survival has a brand new update. So right now there is like some sort of a Decayer's invasion. We can gather these keys and open up these awesome chests. And after we gather 2,000 keys, we'll be able to open up this massive chest and get some of these rewards. So we're gonna be checking this update out. Let's just get out of here. Already prepared. I brought with me here a couple of items. I've heard that this update is all about fire, as these people are Decayer's. So I'm just thinking, you know what? Maybe this snowstorm AK is gonna help me out against those fire zombies, but who knows. So we're gonna hop inside of these events very soon, but first things first, huge thanks to Dota Zombie Survival for sponsoring this video. For those who didn't know, Dota Zombie Survival is an awesome mobile survival game, so make sure to check it out. Link is down in the description. If you love mobile survival games, I'm sure you're gonna enjoy Dota Zombie Survival. So we're gonna start off from an easier location. We're gonna hop to the Iron Wastelands. There's going to be some sort of a basement, and then I feel we're gonna go to other basements. So for example, inside of this old gas station, we can get 10 plus keys, and in Scorchlands we can get 4 plus keys. I don't know, all I know is that we're gonna hop inside of here, as I want to start from something easier. I also know that it's possible to get those keys from the warehouse, so hopefully we'll even check out that warehouse today. Wait, first of all, let's deal with those undertakers. Where is at least one basement? It's showing me where to go. Is it showing me where is that basement or something else? Oh, check this out, peep. Look at that, it's massive. Wait, first of all, let's deal with a couple of these zombies, but this place is massive. I didn't really think it's gonna be that big, but hey, let's hop inside of this place. A flamethrower turret. I'll walk past it when it turns away. Alrighty, I'm not that stupid. I'll probably do that. Alrighty, let's walk past this turret. Let's deal with this guy. Alrighty, I'm going past it. Did I get a little bit of damage? Yes, we set ourselves on fire. We definitely set ourselves on fire. Crypt Warden and vulnerable to cold. And we indeed brought a different gun. So check this out, peeps. We brought this AKM with some snow damage. But it looks like this place is going to be pretty easy. So it's not going to be that big of a deal to deal with them. The radiation level is crazy high. How do I loot this place? I can't do it. The Geiger counter is off the scale. I'm receiving a huge dosage. Shut your mouth and open up the crate. How do I loot that crate? How do I loot that crate? I'm kind of lost. Wait, let's deal with Decayer's Liberator, whatever his name is. Hello, hello. How do I go through here? Oh, the door is already open. I thought there was a door already, so I'm going to avoid that turret. There's also some steam going through. I feel like right now I should be able to go through this place. Let's go. Let's run through it. There are some more Crypt Wardens. Some more damage in the face to them. Here goes, some of them just dropped some loot. Maybe they dropped even some keys. No, we just got some simple rags. And yeah, after that, I'm excited to go and check out the warehouse, because you can get like 70 plus keys from the warehouse. At least that's what I saw there on the minimap. Alrighty, let's go over here. Why my dude is always constantly burning? Probably they've done some damage. That's why my dude is burning. Here we go, there's a big chest. We're gonna definitely open up that big chest. Maybe now I can check out the crate. Yes, now we can go loot the crate. Well, that was pretty easy, but again, this was the most simple location, like the green zone or something, so it's so easy to clear it. But hey, now let's go, let's open it up. Let's loot the Decayer's crate. And usually here we're gonna get only like 2 keys or something from the crate. Yeah, we got 2 keys. They are sent to the PDA. And what do we get here inside of the Decayer's pulpit? The Inquisitors deliver their sermons from this pulpit. All right, doesn't matter really, doesn't matter. Wait, oh, this turret doesn't even work. That's nice. But can I go and loot the weapon rack right now? Maybe not really. Yeah, it's just probably there for the main critical radiation. Use ARAD or another remedy. Oh, and I also forgot to mention that during this update, you'll be able to craft some new items. So you can craft like this provision storage. We'll be able to store food. You can craft a water tank where you can store your water. There's also a Decayer's crate. There's this symbol of the shining and a couple of other items. And there are some more things up the top. You can craft like this decay torch and some other items as well. But hey, now probably I'm going to leave this place because I don't think I have any enter-rads. Alrighty, so I'm back at the base and I do have a little bit of alcohol over here, so we can just drink that. Here go, to reduce some radiation. I might even take that thing with me. So let's go now to this desolated hollow, because it looks like we'll be able to get there 12 keys. And if I die, I lose all of my items. It's scary to go there. Honestly, that's stupid. Like, seriously, that's very stupid to go there. But hey, no risk, no rewards. Am I right? But still, even for the 12 keys, I'm better off just going to the warehouse and not risking everything that I have here, because I have one of my best weapons, Snap Transition, and I'm risking everything. Also, my armor, my healing items. I'm risking everything. This is stupid. This is really stupid. But hey, hopefully somewhere over here we'll be able to find that. Wait, let's deal with these wolfos. Dumb wolfos. Wait, let's deal with some claws. They even do more damage here. I'm probably gonna get my snap transition. And let's try to find that entrance. I don't even know where it will be. First of all, let's deal with these Decayers. I don't think they're gonna drop any useful items. Oh no, there are those mad fireflies. I didn't even take any items for them. Wait, you know what? Let's heal up real quick. I'm gonna take those triad glaives. Let's throw those one triad glaive, another triad glaive, third triad glaive, and now let's deal with the Undertaker. Just being here already caused us lots of troubles. I can only imagine what's gonna happen when we hop inside of that basement. Maybe, but this guy dropped something. Did they drop anything? Just a little bit of water, I guess. Thank you for water. There's a car. Do we loot it? Doesn't really matter. Doesn't really look like it. We can loot that car. Alrighty, another stupid mad firefly. Get out of here, please. Get out of here. Here, well, we dealt with that mad firefly. Here, got another broken car. And there's an entrance! There's an entrance, ladies and gents! So without any further ado, how do I get inside? I need a sledgehammer. No way, I forgot about it. No way. Let's heal up. Almost died. Oh, I do have a pickaxe. So let's use something. I don't have a sledgehammer, but I have a pickaxe. That is something. Wait, let's deal with this. Adapt, decare. Hopefully the pickaxe is gonna be enough. I took that pickaxe because I wanted to go to the warehouse, but hey, that's gonna be enough. Here we go. We opened up the entrance and let's open side now. Let's see what this location is gonna be about. It's a bit different. A basement now. Here, I'm gonna get the gun. I do have healing items. My boots are about to break, but please tell me they're still gonna hold on for quite a while. They're gonna last a bit longer. Here, a couple of more shots and they die. So whenever they're vulnerable to like that ice, they do get lots of extra damage. So all I have to do is just do a couple of shots and then just run away from them. I think they also get maybe slower. Maybe not really. Here, let's deal with that Crypt Warden. It's gonna die really, really soon. Go and die, Schmuck. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. What's going on over here? Maybe I can loot this thing. I don't want to picture the sacrifices it has seen. Where I'm going? I don't even know where I'm going through. No. Maybe I shouldn't be here. Maybe I really shouldn't be here. I feel like, do I really have to be here? I should have went to an easier crypt, first of all. I shouldn't have went here. But hey, let's go through this place. Now, let's go from over here. I'm gonna stay here probably. Oh, no. Well, at least I don't get damage from this side. Alrighty, so it's good. I can stay over here, probably. I can stay over here. No, maybe not really. Maybe not really. Let's go through this. Got a little bit of damage. Let's heal up. Let's still deal with those Crypt Wardens. Dude, I'm gonna get shredded into smithereens. They're even throwing these Molotovs. Once again, healing up. Probably wasting those healing items. No! Don't die, Schmuck! I'm pressing to break open. Heal! Press to break open. Here we go. I got open. Oh, my goodness. There's the break. I didn't even know that. Oh, my goodness. It's just gonna explode. Jeez, that was stupid for me to come here. That was stupid. I'm risking everything basically for nothing. Alrighty, let's get that 750 health. I want to save as many of those things as possible. What are they called? Phoenix Stimulators. There's nothing else I can do. Let's loot the guy. Maybe he dropped at least something useful. We got two rags from it. Thank you very much for the two rags. Really cool. Well, here we go. There's the whirl. I'm gonna throw that thing at it. Another one. Here go, it went sleep. Maybe I can sneak. Maybe that's what I could do. If I sneak attack, maybe I can do more damage. Oh no, we gotta break free. So all you have to do is just tap it really, really quickly. And then you're not gonna get stuck on the traps. Wait, I just realized something. Peeps! You might be like, Psych, what did you realize? Check this out. I have these three trap detectors. What if I take that trap detector and how do I set it? How do I set the trap detector? Maybe we can check it out. I'm just interested in how those trap detectors work. Can I just use the trap detector? I used one. Oh, so that's how it works. For how long is it gonna last? I have no idea, but I activated one trap detector. It must mean something. Let's eat another bandage. Yes, exactly. Eat it. Alrighty. I'm gonna go over here. That's so stupid. Got a little bit of damage through that turret. Oh, no. Gonna get stuck in the trap again. Let's heal up. Let's do this. Let's heal. I'm dead here right now, peeps. I am legitimately dead. I should probably just skedaddle from here. Don't get stuck in the trap. Oh my goodness, what is going on? This is such a hard location, honestly. I kid you not, peeps. Let's heal up once again. And let's deal with that altar right now. So maybe there is a chance that I'm gonna survive. This thing is vulnerable to acid, but I don't have any acidic weapons. So I'm just gonna shoot it with these thingies. Maybe I can even get my snap transition. Snap transition is much better. Oh my goodness, I thought my heart's gonna stop here. Maybe there's a better way to deal with it. Maybe you can sneak. But everything just got too confusing for me, and that's it. So I wanted to do it faster. But hey, we got a little bit of leather. We got some copper wirings. I cannot even check out this altar. But bruh, these things are hard. Here, at least here we got 12 decayer skis. And I don't know, we survived just by luck. We survived by luck. My armor is almost broken. So I feel like we gotta skedaddle from this place. I don't even know for how long this thing lasts. One trap activator. Maybe if you open it, maybe there's a description actually. Reveals nearby traps. Duration 90 seconds. Oh, so that's how it works. So it works for a minute and a half. Okay, understandable. Have a nice day. Well, that's it. We can leave now this place. I think we've gotten everything there is to get from it. Well, that was scary. I think this is the scariest thing I've ever had in Dawn of Zombies. Because most of the other locations aren't that scary. If I die, I'm just gonna be able to get back my loot. But here, nope. The loot's gonna be gone permanently. So check this out, peeps. Soon we will be able to open up this crate. I don't even know for which crate we should go. Should I go, like, maybe for the 100 key crate? Maybe that's the crate we're gonna be going for. I mean, it depends how many keys we're gonna be able to get today. Also, in 2 weeks, there'll be some sort of a challenge. And once again, you'll probably be able to compete against other players and get keys. And right now we just entered a burned restaurant event. I don't think I've ever done this event myself. So this is going to be my first time checking it out. Hey, hopefully my armor is not going to break. There's some sort of a guy. Yo, let's trade. I've always got the wares for you, bro. Alrighty, we can check it out. What do you have for me? You have this gun and the crossbow. And I don't have enough reputation to trade for you for better stuff. Alrighty, doesn't matter then. There's also a boat. Can I touch this boat myself? The dealer's boat, better leave it alone for now, okay? The keyword is for now. We're gonna steal it one day then. So I think over here we're gonna hop inside of the burnt restaurant. And here we will also be able to get those keys. And I'm also excited to hop back for the warehouse because inside of the warehouse we can get more keys. Oh no, actually I've done this event. I think I've done this place before. Say, let's deal with those charred. Once again, I think it's possible to do this place with melee weapons, but guns go brrr. So we're gonna be using that snap transition. Hey, inside of the old suitcase, maybe we'll get those keys. Or maybe we need to kill special zombies and that's where we get the keys. Perhaps, 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 perhaps. I have no idea. Also, do we need here some sort of... I don't even know how those things are called. When we go over here, we can craft them. I just don't remember how they are called. My guy is fighting someone there, but they're pretty easy. Here, like, Strider's pylons. Maybe we require those pylons to do this event, but I might be mistaken. Maybe we need a pylon to open up the door, or maybe no. Already, there's this pylon spot. What is this? I have no idea. I need to throw something there. Here, go ahead. Throw some goop. And requires a pylon, so you do probably need a pylon to be able to go through this place. Required a pylon. No! Alrighty, peeps, so I'm back here in this burnt restaurant event. I brought with me 10 pylons. Hopefully, that is gonna be enough, as I don't really remember how many pylons we need to clear this place. But I did bring 10 of them, so hopefully that's enough. Here go. I think right now we can open up this door. Here go. We can open up the door now. There will be more of those other zombies where I'll have to place those other pylons. Check this. I'm gonna throw this thingy. Oops, throw it in completely wrong guy. Alrighty, so let's try to get back over here. Let's try to throw that item at this thingy. Let's try to set up another pylon. The fire's aberrated. Otherwise, it would have gone by now. I can't even put the pylon here. All right, maybe it's normal. Wait, the guy just exploded in my face. Oh, pylon spot. Here we go. Now we can set up the pylon here. One of them. The second pylon. There's got to be the third pylon then here. Yeah, I mean, just made a mistake. Let's click on it. Here we go. We can set up that pylon. It's kind of stupid. Alrighty, there are a couple of more zombies and so far I still haven't gotten a single special key. I'm interested. Where do I get those keys? When will I get them? Will I get them from some sort of a chest? Wait, there's another devil's candle. Gotta throw that thing at them. Goodbye, devil's candle. Let's open up the door. Although maybe that's where I'll get that loot. I'm parched. I need a drink. Just shut up, mate. We're gonna drink a bit later. Alrighty, let's deal with a couple of claws. Over here, I brought some water, so let's drink. Some more beef chefs. Alrighty, there's another place for the pylon. So I'm gonna throw another thingy. It is gonna explode. I'm gonna set up a third. No, this is actually a fourth pylon. I dealt with fourth pylons and we got a new quest. Place the fifth pylon in the storeroom. Okay, that's what we're gonna do. Here we got some potatoes. And inside of the fridge, we're gonna get four tomato soups. There's also another fridge. We can loot that fridge here as well. Probably we're just gonna get some more food. Oh no, here we got the explosives. Let's get those explosives. Let's open up the storage room. And maybe here we will get those keys. I don't have a clue. Alrighty, there's just a flying tiger. One shot to explode. And somewhere over here, maybe I'll be able to set that pylon. Yes, indeed, there's here go another pylon spot. Let's throw that. Let's set the fifth pylon. Here go. We did that. Quest completed. And what now? New quest. Open the hatch in the back office of the restaurant. Go down to the basement of the burnt restaurant. Alrighty, that's what we're gonna do. There's some loot inside of the racks. So here go. This is the door that we have to open up. And I'm quite certain now when we go lower, that's where we're gonna get those keys. Perhaps, perhaps. We just gotta deal with a couple of extra taggers. Now, let's climb down inside of that basement. Alrighty, check this out. It just opened up, so let's go lower now. I need to look for a place for a pylon in the basement. Alrighty, there's the pylon place. There's another flaming guy. Place the sixth pylon. I placed it. Is there like a seventh pylon or something? Open the door to the boiler room. Alrighty, I'll definitely try that. Here go. Another flaming claw. The dude's gonna explode. We're gonna run through that. Can we open up the door? Yes, we can open up the door easily peasily. The butcher is behind the door. Alrighty, we're gonna put that butcher to sleep. I'm quite sure about that. Alright, so this place looks like something special. Here, there's the butcher. He has 7k health, but it's quite easy with the snap transition. We'll deal with the butcher in a couple of shots. Goodbye, butcher. Goodbye, butcher. Sing your last song. The dude just exploded nearly there. I'll leave it once I set up the last pylon. Alrighty, we're gonna set up the last pylon. And check this out, peeps. Here we can find this special chest. And here we're gonna get 11 of those keys. And the boss dropped us 3 butchers boiling bloods. We can deal that stuff at the restaurant trader. Let's throw that. Let's set up the 7th pylon. I'm pretty sure that it's gonna complete like some sort of a task. I should go on the porch and get my payment. Let's go. Let's get the payment. So here we go. There's the question mark on the minimap. We can talk to this guy. Learn the street speak. It'll come in handy. Street speak. Okay, we'll learn that street speak. So we got this equipment crate. Let's go. Let's get it. And inside of this equipment crate, we got some clothes and we got some weapons. Pretty cool. And the most important, at least for me, that we got 10 of those explodey things. They're always worth it. So Kego, we've gotten these 3 boiling bloods that we can exchange with this dealer. Kego, we just got that sniper rifle. Pretty cool. How much damage does that sniper rifle do? It does 2,407 damage. That's nice. And now we're gonna hop inside of this warehouse. As you can see here, we get 70 plus keys. So I'm interested on where we're gonna get those keys. Will those keys be at the very end, or maybe those keys are just gonna be scattered throughout the entire warehouse? I'm interested in that. Alrighty, so we are inside of the warehouse. I did bring with me here a couple of hatchets to be able to open up the door. Let's deal with those bandit ghouls. And seriously, where on earth will I be getting those keys? Do I get them just from random zombies, or will I get them at the end of the basement? I mean, so many questions and yet no answers. We're gonna get those answers pretty soon. Also, during the last episode, we realized that we need to assemble some sort of a generator. So hopefully we don't need that generator in order to get those keys. Alrighty, let's deal with another tagger over here. There's this bloody hole, but I did bring with me a couple of torches so I can get this torch. I can destroy this bloody hole with a torch. Does it have some fire damage? Yes, it also gets some extra fire damage. This way we don't have to waste those Molotovs. Here we go, just burn down. Here we can get those items that later we can give to the dealer. Let's get back my snap transition. Alrighty, so over here I can even start using the pickaxe. Should I use the pickaxe or should we go over here? Maybe let's go first of all. Let's loot the top floor. We will check it out. Here we go. There's the bully ghoul. Goodbye, mate. Goodbye, bully ghoul. Bully ghoul. It sounds kind of weird when you say it. Bully ghoul. What is bully ghoul? All right, let's get back the torch. Let's equip it. And let's try to destroy that bloody hole. Once again, one shot. How long does it last, the fire damage? Does the fire damage stack? Here, I'm going to do a couple of extra shots. And I think the fire damage maybe lasts longer. Maybe the fire damage stacks. I have no idea. But over here, we're going to get some more of those bloody tears. Let's open up the door. And still, so far, I haven't seen a single key. So maybe those keys are going to be available at the very end. But hey, there's only one way to know that is if we finish the entire warehouse. So that's what I'm planning to do. That's what I'm about to do. Let's go. Killer ghoul. Goodbye, killer ghoul. Also, there's some sort of a big zombie. Maybe that bigger zombie is going to drop some sort of a different gear. No, this is just a beef. This is just a simple guy. Alright, so check this out. There are a couple of taggers. They just destroyed that door. Did they always destroy that door? This is the first time when I see that they destroyed that door. Maybe they always do that, but it's just the first time that I noticed that. Here go. We leveled up here once again. Let's deal with this tagger. And just as always, I still don't have the lockpicks. Alright, there's another bloody hole for that. I'm just gonna get the torch. Just as always, let's get the torch. Let's destroy this bloody hole. And so far, not a single key. So far, not a single key. Let's get back my snap transition. Let's deal with that warehouse. Carnifex. Did it drop anything useful? Not really. Let's go through this place. There's a chest up the top. Oh no, it's gonna explode. I remember that bloodstained chest. It's gonna explode. It's gonna explode. Does it always explode? It didn't explode, so it doesn't always explode. That's weird. That's weird. That's seriously weird. It doesn't always explode then. Can I open up this door? Yes, we can open up this door as well. And behind this door, there's just a simple bandit ghoul. Goodbye, bandit ghoul. There's another bandit ghoul that we can deal with. We can now loot this chest. This chest might explode though. Will it explode in the face? No, it did not explode. Well, here I can open up another door. Let's get the door. Now there are gonna be a bunch of taggers. We can deal with them. Here goes sayonara taggers. And there's one more door up the top. Let's open up the door. Alrighty, so here maybe we're gonna get some sort of keys from these guys then. Let's go. Let's just heal up. I probably haven't even looted the rest of the guys. Maybe some of them dropped something useful as well. Alrighty, so this guy dropped us a key. Nice. We got some sort of a key, but that's not where we loot. Oh, there's one of those chests. Yes, finally, we found one of those chests in the warehouse. How many keys are we going to get here? 5? 10? We got 7 keys. Nice. But that's not it. That's only the beginning. That is only the beginning for us. Oh no, that thing exploded. Yikes. Let's get the storage. Let's destroy one more bloody hole. Can I open up this door? Yes, I guess. We could definitely open up this door. Let's heal up and here we go. There's this bully ghoul and I don't even know if I want to use that key because here we can open up this door with the cell key, but I might keep that cell key for something later. Maybe there's going to be a special door that will require this cell key and from that door, perhaps I'll be able to get more of those decayer's keys to get better loot. That's what we're gonna do. So how many keys we have already? We have 42 keys, so we could open up at least one of those chests, but hey, no, we're not doing that. I'll do my best, as I said, to get that one crate with at least 100 of those keys. That's worth 100 keys. So let's start chopping up this blocked passage. I'm interested how many zombies are gonna spawn. Usually they spawn here. Charred are coming, should have burned the holes. You already burned the holes, haven't you? Maybe we haven't burned all the holes. Wait, I'm interested, where are they coming from if I haven't burned the holes? I've burned the holes. I've done everything. They spawned out of nowhere. They've spawned out of illegal places. Can I open up this door? Door's locked from the inside. So yeah, we dealt with all of the guys. Oh, there's another door over here. We might have not opened this place yet. Yeah, maybe here we are gonna find more bloody holes. Burn bloody holes, 4 out of 5. So yeah, there still has to be one more hole. And those, because there are more bloody holes beyond this blocked passage. So yeah, probably didn't do everything in this place. Let's go, let's deal with another charn. I think over here we could heal up with this artifact. Here go, let's use it just to save up that other thingy. Let's deal with the beef. Can I open up this room? Yes, we could. But hey, we're gonna, as I said, we're still gonna save those cell keys. Here we can get saltpeter. So let's try to open up that door while my artifact is protecting me from the deep ones because there's like this predatory moss and it does some damage. And here we go. I can see already one more of those bloody holes on the minimap. So let's deal with another ghoul. Let's get this torch, actually. And you know what? We're gonna shred that into smithereens. No. Whatever. Let's loot the dead guy. Let's get the loot. And let's try to destroy that predatory moss. Goodbye, predatory moss. Goodbye. Here we go. Just like that, we're gonna burn now this bloody hole. And hopefully now when I'll be using that pickaxe, they're not gonna be attacking me for no reason. Let's go. Let's get the items for the healer. Let's take him. Here we go. The hole is burned. We can open up the chest. Maybe it's gonna explode. Maybe it won't. I don't even know which chest explode. How do you know that? We just got some robber over there. Alrighty, let's get back the snap position just in case they attack us. And hey, let's go. Let's start clearing this passage. And it looks like no one's attacking us. So if we clear this entire place before we open up this passage, that means other zombies are not gonna attack us. That's kind of cool. I'm gonna remember that for the next time. And here we go. There's the ramming ghoul. I think we can deal with them straight away. So we've gotten only 7 keys. There's still 60, basically 3 extra keys left, at least. So there's still a bunch of stuff that we could get here. Go, another ghoul. Another shot. Just a simple stinger. Hopefully my armor is gonna last here because I got brand new armor from the base, but it might get broken. Oh wow, it already got broken a lot. Here go, this dead body might drop another one of those keys. No. Where's the guy then? Alrighty, so apparently that dude didn't even drop me the key. I thought that we'll get some sort of special key from him, but that wasn't even a boss. Let's deal with those raider ghouls. And I'm pretty sure this is probably the best place to get those keys. Because you could clear those green locations, but there you only get 2 keys. Here you can get 70 keys. So it looks like warehouse gives you the highest amount of those decay keys. Alrighty, there's that other thing up the top. Gotta be careful and not approach it too close. So we're gonna deal now with those simple beefs before we start dealing with the turret. Now let's go, let's try to deal with that turret. Oh no, another claw. Get out of here. Seriously, get out of here. We gotta burn the holes. How many holes there are? 3 holes. Alrighty, claw, goodbye. Risen carnifex, goodbye. So probably 1 extra shot. And you're dead. No, actually, 2 shots. Here, go. Goodbye, mate. Now, let's deal with that turret. Let's heal up. Another shot. Kind of sad that you cannot dodge that. Maybe you can dodge it a little bit. Here, go. The turret got destroyed. Some more killer ghouls. Some more beefs. Wait, I just noticed that even when you look at them, you can see that they have some sort of armor. I always look at their health, but I never really looked at these guys. But check this out. They have some sort of armor. And you can see when you shoot at them that armor has some sort of effects, how it's breaking. That is interesting. Let's go. Let's deal with that claw. There's another claw. Oh, and also we got the turret here, so we can loot the turret. And this turret dropped us some iron ingot springs and some wires. Alrighty, so this thing is not going to be openable, obviously, because, yeah, I'll get damage. I already tried that in the past. What I could do, though, is get back my torch. But where did I keep it? Where did I drop my torch? Well, I cannot see my torch for some reason, so I'm just going to throw these Molotovs then. but you require like 2 Molotovs to deal with that. I don't know where I dropped my torch, honestly. I'm lost. I'm sure I didn't break that torch unless it broke, but I kind of doubt it. Already we opened up this door. There's another bloodstained box, but where did I drop the torch? Here we get some rebars. Already, so let's open up the door, and that's where we can save a bunch of survivors, and maybe there we're gonna get some chests. Let's go. But so far I don't get it. Where's my loot? It said I'll get 70 keys. Where are my 70 keys? Captain Ghoul. Sayonara, Captain Ghoul. More like Captain Dead, am I right? Haha. They do a lot of damage. These Captain Ghouls do a lot of damage. They shred me to smithereens. Nobody gotta heal up. Okay, we dealt with that big Captain Ghoul. Now we can deal with this Killer Ghoul. Did Captain Ghoul drop us another Selkie or something? Yes, it dropped us a Selkie. Can I open up this door? Yes, indeed, we can also open up this door. I'm poshed, I need a drink. Dude, aren't you drinking too much? Let's go, let's drink some more water. Another Chieftain Ghoul. Maybe this guy's gonna drop another thing as well. Mayhaps, mayhaps. Already, so the Stinger attacked me as well. Let's deal with that Stinger. Now we can do one more shot in here, but that Captain Ghoul is dead. Please tell me you're gonna give me a key as well. Yes, we're gonna get another key from you. Thank you very much. Alrighty, so over here, there's a workshop box. Inside of this workshop box, we can get these items. We can get the shower faucet. We can get some more saltpeter and some copper parts. And here we go. We've just looted the bike, and we were able to get some copper wires and 3 screws. But hey, all of that is awesome, but where on earth are my chests? Alrighty, so though, that thing is healing them. Alrighty, got it. Got it, got it, got it. Stop attacking me! Just stop it! Just stop it. Carnifex has arisen. Burn all the bloody holes. Stop it. We will burn them. We will burn them. I just realized that, you know what? When he says bloody hole, he means like that the hole is bloody. But at the same time, it's like a bloody hole. Oh, over here we got another key. Here we go. Torture room key. Let's get that. And there's like an artifact, so I'm pretty sure we can use it straight away. So here we go. We can use that artifact. And my dude is hungry. Let's go. Let's eat a little bit. Let's drink some more water. And let's go to this place. Alrighty, so there are more killer ghouls. Well, at least these killer ghouls are quite easy to deal with. Here, goodbye, killer ghoul. Now we can just deal with this bloody altar. Some more killer ghouls, which are just simple, easy, easy to deal with. Let's go. Another shot. And another shot. Wait, can I get more chests here? Yes, there's another chest here. Please tell me it gives me like 60... thing is 60. We got 14, so that's at least something. But still, there are a bunch of more keys to get. Maybe for that, you're required to have the full engine, maybe. Well, whatever. Let's go. Let's throw one of those Molotovs. Let's throw one more Molotov on that bloody hole. Here can get more items for the dealer. So I'm gonna let this guy go. I'm gonna let another guy go. And where do I get extra chests? Probably you need to have that generator then. Probably that's where you'll get more of them. Here go. Thank you. Here go. We got some another item from that guy. As a thanks, we got another double teardrop or whatever. I never opened up this cell. I want to just open up this cell. What can we get from it? I'm interested. What do we get from this cell? Here go. I opened it up. Is there anything useful from this guy? Another double thingy. So yeah, sadly, we don't really get 70 of those keys, but it looks like it is possible to get at least like 20 keys just from the location that we cleared here in the warehouse. But yeah, it looks like you need to assemble the generator, then you'll be able to get through this door, and maybe there you can find more decayer keys. Alrighty, so I'm back at the base. Let's go, let's take a shower, and then I feel like we should go and visit one of those decayers' basements, caves, or whatever they're called. Alrighty, so we are now in the Quiet Grove. Let's just find one extra of those crypts. Probably they're gonna be called crypts. Alrighty, there's some sort of a basement. We don't really have to go there, as that's not where we find those chests. Is that the crypt? Here go, peeps. One more crypt. But hey, before this, let's deal with all of these schmucks. Yeah, I think they're done, though. Here go, one more chart. Goodbye, mate. So let's hop inside of this decayer's crypt. Alrighty, there's another turret. We're just gonna run past the turret because we kind of already know how to do this place. One shot in the face. Can I loot these weapon crates? I mean, last time I could. They told me that I can't loot. Can I loot it right now? I'm irradiated again. So as soon as I touch it, I get radiation. Is that what's going on? Is that what's up? Then what's the point of that weapon rack here? As soon as I touch it, check this out. I'm touching it again. The radiation level is crazy high. As soon as I touch it, it gets more radiation. Okay, so maybe that's not how you open it up. Maybe that's not how you open it up. Alrighty, another one of those dudes goes to sleep, sleep. And I do know that if you're gonna clear this green location multiple times, it becomes harder. It's gonna look a bit different on the map. And yeah, the difficulty is gonna reset in 24 hours, if I'm not mistaken. Alrighty, over here, there's another one of those chests. Didn't really mean to go through the fire there. Didn't expect that it's gonna damage us so much. Here go, Crypt Warden, goodbye. Now you can go and loot the chest. Yes, now we can go and loot the chest. We can get there 2 extra of those keys, which is much faster to get them than by doing the warehouse. I expect that we can get 70 keys from the warehouse, but hey. Well, it looks like we were not able to get 100 of those points, but hey, at least we got 58 points. 58 of those keys, I mean. So this way we can go and unlock this crate. So let's go. Let's unlock one of those crates. It costs only 25. So from this first crate, we are going to get the wrench and 5 of those items, which can restore our health, hunger, and whatever. Alrighty. Let's get those rewards. Let's try to open up one extra of those crates. And inside of the second crate, we got a gun. We got another 5 of those Pepsis, whatever they are. And another piece of armor. And check this out. Whatever we are opening up here, those keys and those points are going towards this bigger chest. This Inquisitor's cargo chest. So make sure to check out Donna Zombie Survival yourself. Link is down in the description. As I said, if you're enjoying mobile survival games, I'm sure you're gonna love Donna Zombies. So I highly suggest you check it out to my first ever Donna Zombie Survival video. Or click on the second card and you'll go to my previous Donna Zombie Survival video. Or hop over to my channel, go to playlist, and there you'll find a lot of other games that I played here on the channel. If you're not subscribed yet, definitely make sure to jump the subscribe button and notification bell to not miss any future videos, and consider following me on Instagram or Twitter at Abyssyric. Yep.